anybody in this house other than me that can declare you made it. Tell your neighbor, never would have made it. Tell them, never could have made it. Oh, I wish I had some help here. I wish I had just two or three people that would just declare it. Never would have made it. Never could have made it.
Family, can we stand?
Thank you, man.
The Lord in his house, and we trust him not with some things, but we have to trust him with everything. David said, the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. David said, he make me to lie down in green pastures and he restores my soul. David also said that, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. David said, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I would dwell in the house of the Lord forever. David said that when the Lord began to reveal his strength and his power, he would yield, because God always knows what's best. The earth and everything in it, the world and its inhabitants belong to the Lord. And he laid his foundation on the seas and established it upon the rivers. Who may ascend the mountains of the Lord? Who may stand in his holy place? The one who has clean hands and a pure heart, who has not appealed to what is false, who has not sworn deceitfully, he will receive blessings from the Lord and righteousness from the God of his salvation. Such is the generation of those who inquire of him, who seek the face of the God of Jacob. So lift up your heads, O ye gates, rise up, your ancient doors. Then the King of glory will come in. Who is the King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty. The Lord mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, you gates. Rise up, your ancient doors. Then the King of glory will come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord of armies. He is the King of glory.
He restoreth my soul.
set.
We're going to ask you to come down this center aisle. Once we close this casket lid, it will not be opened up in the service again. So if you have not had an opportunity to come and pay your final respects, I'm going to ask you to come down that center aisle. Because once we close this casket lid, it will not be reopened in the service. Marke 35, was born July 1st, 1987, in Houston, Texas, to the parents of Gregory Marke of Houston and Donald Fort Marke of Wharton, Texas. She was the eldest of their two children. In the late 1990s, Melanie and her family moved to Missouri City. As a small child, she was always filled with laughter, danced often, and seemed to never run out of energy. She also spent a great deal of time with family and friends. The people closest to her will forever remember her fiery, fun-loving spirit, infectious laugh, and everlasting loyalty. In her adult years, she loved watching movies, dancing, and listening to her favorite artists, such as Ari Lennox. She also enjoyed spending time in the kitchen with her son, Corey, passing on her expertise in things such as seafood pasta and party staples. In addition, through many intimate conversations with Layla, her many best friend and niece, she has helped to mold her into who she is today. Melanie's most celebrated talent was being master hairstylist. You best believe she worked some miracles on some real African-American hair and was amazing at it. Melanie, in 2005, the Thurgood Marshall High School graduate, where she served as part of the Junior ROTC program as a senior officer. She was the center of many friendship circles and carried on those friendships throughout the years. She will forever be missed by everyone blessed to be a part of her life. Melanie accepted Christ at a very young age. She was a member of Willow Ridge Baptist Church in her early years and later became a member of the Church at Bethel's family in her adult years. Melanie passed from this life Sunday, February the 5th, 2023. She's preceded in death by her paternal and maternal grandparents, Georgia Mae Marks and John Henry Marks II, O.D. Ford Sr., and Mabel Roford, paternal and maternal aunts and uncles. Ernest Ford, we're ready, Brock, Mabel Ann, Dolores Hayes, Pauline Ford, Patricia Gardner, Theola Bonner, and Tommy Skinner. Melanie leave to cherish her memories, her two beautiful children, Corey Hall Jr. and Marley Middleton, her parents, Gregory Marks and Donald Mark Ford Marks, her sister, Jasmine Marks, Sinflor, Joshua Sinflor, her nieces, Layla Coleman, her godparents, O.D. Ford Jr. and Brenda Ford, and a host of uncles, aunts, cousins, and friends.
I shall wear a crown. I shall wear a crown. When it's all over, when it's all over, I shall see his face. I shall see his face, face one day. But when it's all over, yes, when it's all over, all I'm going to put on my robe and tell the story how I made it over. Yeah, 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 she's gonna put on her robe and tell her story how she made it over. If you know it, help me sing it. Yeah, she's gonna put on, she's gonna put on her robe and tell her story how she made it, how she made it, how she made it over. She's gonna put on her robe and tell how she made it, how she made it. No more crying, no more weeping, no more depression. She's gonna put on her robe. Hey, 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 yeah. How she made it all. Oh.
family, we're here to celebrate the life of our dear sister Melanie Catrice Marks. The family has already laid out a program for us to process through. There will be Old Testament reading from Pastor Otis Carey, New Testament reading, Reverend Kelvin Murphy, prayer of comfort, Pastor Marcus Holman, there of Bethel's family. There will be an inspirational song from the mighty men of Bethel. Then we have a church resolution. Sister Betty Peacock will read those. There should be some slide presentation that would go on. And then due to the family's request, it won't be seven people. We will take four people that will include a family member. And I need to remind you is that this is hard for the family, so if you can't hold it together, you might as well stay in your seat. I don't like to embarrass anybody, but this is not the church where you come from. The other thing, we have a song of preparation, Miss Angelica Rodriguez, and the message of hope, and then we will turn back over to our directors. So your three preachers, let's come and let's follow our instructions.
Giving greetings to the Father, to the family, and to all that assemble. In the Old Testament, reading scripture come from the book of Psalms, 67 numbers of Psalms. And it reads, God be merciful unto us and bless us and cause his face to shine upon us, that thy way may be known upon the earth, thy saving health among all nations. Let the people praise thee, O God. Let all the people praise thee. O let the nations be glad and sing for joy. For thou shalt judge the peoples righteously and govern the nations upon the earth. Let the people praise thee, O God. Let all the people praise thee. Then shall the earth yield her increase. And God, even our own God, God shall bless us, and all the ends of the earth shall fear him.
The New Testament reads as the 14th chapter of St. John said, let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God, be ye also in me. For in my Father's house are many mansions, and if it wasn't so, I would have told you. I go and prepare a place for you, and if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again unto myself and receive you unto myself, that there I am, where there I am, there ye may be also. And I will leave you, I will not leave you comfortless. I will come to you yet a little while, and the world see me no more, but ye see me because I live, yet shall live also. Peace leave, I leave with you. Peace unto you, I give unto you. Let as the world give, and I give unto you, let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. 14th chapter of St. John. Amen.
Family, can we bow? Our heads bowed, our hearts humbled before the Lord our God. Father, it is in the name of Jesus that we come before you. Lord, as the question of why is running around in our heads, Father, we know that you are a sovereign God and that nothing happens apart from your will. But Father, in these moments, I pray that you would make yourself known. Father, that you would reveal yourself in a very intimate way to those who are hurting the most. Father, your word says that absent from the body means to be present with the Lord. And although our hearts may be heavy, we know ultimately that Sister Melanie is in the best place that she could ever be. So comfort this family, comfort her loved ones, her friends, Lord, all of those whose hearts are heavy right now, because we know that you can do everything except fail. So Father, have your way in this place today. Move as you will move. And Father, when it is all said and done, if there be one that has never confessed you as Lord and Savior, may this be the day that they get in right standing with you. We pray this, Lord, believing that you've heard it and that you've already sent the answer. It is in Jesus' name, amen, and thank God.
morning. Our condolences to the Boss family. Clap your hands.
Clap your hands if you love the Lord.
If you love the Lord.
Love the Lord.
Can I get somebody?
Clap your hands. Some sanctified believers right now. Come on and clap your hands. Come on and clap your hands. Yeah. Come on and clap your hands. Yeah. Clap them like you're gonna clap them off. Clap your hands.
Everybody.
Clap your hands.
Come on now.
Clap your hands.
Clap your hands.
His holy name.
Praise, the Lord.
Praise His name in the morning.
Praise, the Lord.
Praise His name in the evening.
Oh!
in my bones.
Sister Melanie today. Amen. Amen. We offer our prayers of comfort to the Marks family, to Donna, Greg, Corey. God bless you. And you too, baby. Amen. Whereas the power of keeping alive belongs to God. And whereas one day we will be putting off this old tabernacle. Whereas it is written, for dust thou art, and to dust thou shalt return. Be resolved that on Sunday, February 5th, 2023, the soul of Melanie Catrice Marks was required. The pastor and members of Bethel's family, except along with Job, there's an appointed time to man upon this earth. And in that knowledge, we extend our deepest sympathy to the Marks family. Be it further resolved that although death has come into our windows and entered into our church family, the Lord God will swallow up death in victory, and he will wipe away all tears from all faces. All praises and glory be unto God, for God is mighty, God is love, God is wise, righteous, and he is faithful. All that we have needed, his hands has provided, God has promised. I will not leave you comfortless. I will come to you. He's always kept his promises. Lean up on him and he will guide you all the way. All power, glory, and dominion belongs to God. Humbly submitted in love, Walter August Jr., Senior Pastor. We'd like to also acknowledge from Willow Ridge Baptist Church, where the pastor is Dr. Clifton Montgomery Jr., and from New Hope Missionary Church, where the pastor is Reverend Charles Jones. God bless.
Amen.
I give myself away so you
And family, at this moment, we will begin to start our time of expressions. And I want to encourage us that this is a very sensitive time. And Miss Melanie can't hear anything that you're going to say in this service. And so I want you to know that it's a time to encourage this family. A story of encouragement, something you did that was wonderful. So if God have laid something on your heart and you want to be a part of that early number I spoke about, I'm going to have you come and stand now so we don't have gaps after one speaker to another. It's not required, but we do want to give an invitation. I'm going to ask all of the clergy, those who preach the gospel of Christ, if you're here, would you please stand? You might be representing a church family, and I need to make sure we acknowledge your presence here because of this family. If you don't mind, sir, go ahead and share your name and your church family, and we'll go across the room, if you don't mind, and exactly in what city and state it's the ministry in. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. Brother Clark, hold on, baby. Brother Clark, since you came, I think, to Fathers, would you come and give an encouraging word on behalf of all the clergy that's here? And then, baby girl, you'll be coming up from the family perspective. I got you. Bless you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Let us all say amen. Amen. Let us all say amen again. To this wonderful family, Greg and Donna and the rest of the family, and to all who have come to celebrate in this homegoing service. In times like these, I just really don't have the wit to know what to say. So I am present. God bless you. I'm praying for you.
Hello, everybody. For those that don't know me, I'm Melanie's little sister. I really just wanted to come up here and thank all of you guys for all of the support, the food. Oh, my God, the food. We literally don't have any room in the refrigerator because of all of the food. But we haven't had to go and buy food not one time, so we appreciate that. This was really sudden, I know she's feeling a lot better. My sister struggled a lot here, so I find comfort in the fact that she's up there with all the rest of our family, and she's with the people who like to party, so she's gonna be good. But really, I just wanted to thank y'all. It has been, I've never seen nothing like this, y'all. Our house has been full every day. My text messages have been full every day. So thank y'all. That really helps.
Hey, everybody. My name is Layla, if y'all don't know. I'm my Amy's niece, her mini best friend. I just want to start off by thanking everybody for coming out to support. The support system is amazing, first of all. I just want to say that I love my Amy very much. She was always there for everybody in this room. She was the party person of the family. Anytime we seen her, she was always laughing and smiling, even with the problems that she faced. And I just want to thank you all again for coming out. And yeah, that's all I had to say.
Hello, everyone. there's no words that can even begin this. I can't even think of it right now. I'm just going to go off the head, you know, go with my feelings. I loved my mom very much. We had a bond like no other. You know, she was a cool and great mom to me. Best one you could have, I can tell you that much. It was definitely a shock when I first found out. But I've had the support from friends and family all week, and I appreciate y'all for that. You know, thank y'all for coming through for me whenever I needed y'all. And I guess all I have to say last is I'm gonna miss you, Mama.
Miss Rodriguez, you're ready for that song. Bless you.
And you feel all alone, but hold on, 'cause better days are coming. It could be rough in this world. I know it ain't easy, but hang on in there. I know better. Happy and sad. and never lose sight. I know people they didn't see the hurt you cry, but you gotta hold on, 'cause everything will be alright. Better days. Woo.
And family, may we bow, please. Most gracious Heavenly Father, we just say thank you, Lord. Thank you, God, for everything that's been done. And we thank you, Lord, for holding on to us. God, when we can't hold on to ourselves. And Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, God, continue to heal, restore, and reconcile, God, the body around this family. Allow them to know that, God, you're not asleep, nor are you slumbering. There's nothing that happens, God, that escapes you. God, you're the one who created Melanie. You're the one who placed her in this family. And according to your own divine word, God, when she was fashioned and woven in the depths of the earth, God, only you saw her unformed body. And all the days of her life was already ordained and sanctioned, God, before one of them came to be. So right now, God, we ask that you would just comfort through your word, Master. Encourage the listeners, God, that, God, we can continue to focus and trust in you. We love you, Lord. We bless you. It's in Jesus' name that we pray, and we say amen. Amen. My family and friends, on behalf of the Marks family, Pastor Clark words are definitely in line. Sometimes there are no human words that can soothe or bring a level of understanding of what we are dealing with. Not just on this occasion, but on many occasions. As the senior pastor of our church here, we all grieve when families are going through the grieving process. We're all interconnected one to the other. You might be from a different community, a different family, but at the end of the day, death have a way of aligning us all up. I was blessed to be able to know a little bit about Melanie in our early years as a teenager going into young adulthood. But you know, when you get my age and you're in my generation, there's a strong disconnect from my generation to the generation of my son Patrick, who is in Melanie's generation. And then we have generational struggles. We have a society that have lice and things that are wrong. Our young people are caught into a web of confusion. The government sanctioned things that God say no. The people of God begin to live a life wandering in the wilderness when we've already been to the promised land. But on behalf of the Marks family, and it was a blessing to see Brother Marks up here doing what he's supposed to do. And good to see Sister Mark standing and worshiping the Lord in spite of the pain and the hole that's in their hearts. It reminded me of 2 Samuel when King David and the baby that he and Bathsheba had birthed. It said that baby was born sickly. But I'll read the text and I won't be before you long. But this is an important message, not for some of us, but for all of us. In the 12th chapter of 2 Samuel, beginning there at verse number 15, it says, the Lord struck the baby that Uriah's wife had born to David. And he became deadly ill. David pleaded with God for the boy. He fasted. He went home and spent the night lying on the ground. The elders of the house stood beside him to get him up from the ground, but he was unwilling and would not eat anything with them. On the seventh day, the baby died. But David's servants were afraid to tell him that the baby was dead. They said, look, while the baby was alive, we spoke to him, and he wouldn't listen to us. So how can we tell him the baby is dead? He may do something desperate. Verse 19 says, when David saw that his servants were whispering to each other, he guessed that the baby was dead. So he asked his servant, is the baby dead? He is dead, they replied. Then David got up from the ground. He washed, anointing himself, changed his clothes, and went to the Lord's house and worshiped. Then he went home and requested something to eat. So they served him food, and he ate. His servants asked him, why have you done this? While the baby was alive, you fasted and wept. But when he died, you got up and ate food. He answered, while the baby was alive, I fasted and I wept because I thought, who knows? The Lord may be gracious to me and let him live. But now that he is dead, why should I fast? Can I bring him back again? But I'll go to him. And he will never return to me. May the Lord add a blessing to the readers and hearers and doers of his word. The common denominator for every human being is death. You can avoid paying your taxes. You can avoid getting car insurance. You can avoid speaking to people. You can even choose not to love people. You can choose to live your life as an angry person. But there is one thing that you cannot choose. And that's a date with death. Job said that man born of a woman is only of a few days. And these days are filled with so much trouble. When we came into the earth, we were born into sin, shaped in iniquity. Who knows what tomorrow holds for any of us? But we know there's a pending date for all of us, that death is real. This physical death is permanent. And so David found himself in the midst of the child's struggle. And Marks, Brother Marks, please believe this. You're not the only parents that's struggling. Other people's hide their challenges. Don't want folks to know they got some, amen, kids on some stuff. We live in a very fake world. You've been told to fake it until you make it. Amen. Be strong even when you're weak. Look like you're alive when you're dead. That's why the makeup industry, cosmetic surgery, all these painted on smiles, all this fake joy of the Lord. Praise the Lord, he's good. But when you're by yourself, and you're all alone thinking about your kids and grandkids, your nieces and your nephews, that pain is real. And there's not a family and a parent, a grandparent, an auntie, uncle in this house that don't have some sense of caution and concern about their children. Sometimes we handle it a little differently. We've been conditioned. Don't show your weakness. Don't show your stress. Don't show when you're going through. But I come by to tell you that God knows. God knows everything. And for times like these, we have to begin to say, David, talk to us. And I'm sure the Marks, along with every other family, including my wife and I, for our own children, our own grandchildren. There are nights we can't sleep. Can I get a witness in here? There's a night we toss and turn, we're struggling about worrying where they are, what's going on in their life. God, please protect them. We can't protect them, God. They won't listen to us, God. They think they're grown, God. They think they've figured it out, God. Can I get a witness in here? Go to bed, our heart is hurting, literally. Waking up thinking we have a heart attack, we're having a stroke because of the stress of our children. The love we have for them. But David was in that same zone. This little baby that he and Bathsheba bore was struggling. And every child, regardless of the age, no matter how old your children are, you'll still be parenting. You can be 99 and a half and have a 79-year-old son, you're going to still be his parents. As long as there's breath in your body as a parent, you will always be parenting. Even though our children look at us as though we don't know what we're doing, we haven't been anywhere, sometimes you got to sit down with your parents and get the real story. We didn't get here this long, amen, just doing our own thing. Can I just go ahead and throw in a nugget to some of you young people in here, including my own children? This world is already in a fix to take you out of here. The Bible is very clear that Satan come to steal, kill, and destroy. And he will use the feeble-minded, the mind that allow themselves to go down the road thinking you're independent from God. You can call your own shots. You can do your own thing. You're sadly mistaken out there. Satan is real. He's real. He set up a plan for your life. When you have godly parents and godly mothers and grandmothers, that means Satan, if he can't get your mom and dad to shake it loose, he can't get your grandparents to shake it loose, he'll start dealing with you. There's a big gulf between young adults coming to church, getting involved, giving their life to Christ, using their gifts and skills to the Lord, because somewhere somebody has told a lie that coming to church don't matter anymore. I just do it the way I need to do it. But I come by to tell you, the devil's still lying to a lot of folks. We got to get our head out of the sand and begin to call things what they are. I thank God my mother brought me to church. I thank God I got a relationship when I was a kid. I thank God I love Amazing Grace. I thank God, he's on the main line. I can call him anytime I get ready. I'm so glad I know that God has smiled on me. I'm so glad about the songs that brought me over, that's carrying me right now.
And those same songs, my little children, my little young people, my young adults, it's the same song that was good enough for mama and daddy and grandparents. They're still good enough to you for you. Yes, Rihanna and Beyonce, they singing a whole lot of stuff. Noop is doing his thing. Kanye West is doing his thing. But they can't bring you to Jesus. They can't show you at grace and mercy. Come on now, say amen. You can wear your clothes like you want to. You can have your attitude like you want to. But I come by to tell you, one day, very soon, it won't be long, the death angel will call your name. Is that hide and seek program ready or not? Here I come. So while David was praying and fasting, child was struggling. Those around him began to look at him. They were afraid of him because he's King David. David wouldn't even sleep. Because he was in deep prayer hoping God would spare the child. Now mind you, that child was conceived out of sin. Don't look around, because many of us were too. Don't look around, don't point at nobody. Y'all know we got some Louisiana blood in here. Come on, I say amen. Your mom and daddy had you in thought when they was amen, huffing and puffing like the wolf along with the three little pigs. Come on, I say amen. But when God brought that child home, David got up. David went and washed himself, anointed himself, got him something to eat, and he went to the house of the Lord, and he began to worship and praise God, because David knew that heaven is a real place. And it's a real place for prepared people who have made their reservations. So when they came to him and inquired, what's going on with you? And I know some of you, especially you brothers sitting out there watching Brother Marks, come up here. Say, what is he doing? Why is he up there? His child is gone. You got to understand something. Brother Mark is saved. And saved for a long time. Didn't you see the mama standing and praising God? Somebody ought to say amen. They have a relationship with the Lord. They know that baby girl was only for them for a little while on this side. And they did all they could to make sure baby girl had everything she needed for the journey in which she was on. They making sure that Corey and the baby girl will have everything they need. They've insulated themselves with love. And that's why love follows them. That's why they can praise the Lord like it's going out of style. That's why they can give God glory, praise, and honor, because they know that God is real. And when David said, listen, there's nothing I can do to bring the child back to me, but I prepare myself to see my child again one day. Come on now, say amen. And so the guarantee of salvation is that when these old eyes finally close and the last breath proceeds from this body, we have a home in glory that's not made with the hands of men. A matter of fact, Reverend Murphy said it like this. Jesus says in John 14, he says, listen, in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would tell you, but I go to a place to prepare a place for you, and where I am, there you shall be also with me. And verse 6 says, listen, Jesus says, I am the way. I am the truth and the life. He says, no man go into the Father except by me. Can I close with this? Because you got to realize that it's a hallelujah time. This baby girl is home. There's nothing in this casket. Come on now, say amen. Everything you thought you knew is no longer here. This is the old shell. Come on now, say amen. That we walk around with. That's why you ought not to put too much attention on your exterior. Come on now, say amen. You ought to put something about your interior. Talk about your soul. Come on now, say amen. Stop trying to please people with these funky hairdos and this and that on the outside and all of this, that, and the other. That means nothing. That's a style. It
fades out. I remember the afro, Brother Marks, it went out of style. I remember the jerry curl, Pastor Jones, it went out of style. I remember the fade on the backside with the little ducktail on the back, that went out of style. Some of you older people, that old punker do you had in front of your head, that went out of style. Come on now, say amen. But the only thing that never go out of style is your relationship with the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. He's Jesus all by himself. Anybody know his name in here? You see, when you know his name, you can have joy in the midst of your pain, in your struggles, in your frustration. So we're not sad. We're not mad. We rejoice with this baby girl. She's graduated. She's home. Revelation 21. No more pain. No more suffering. No more hospital visits. No more haters. No more jealousy. No more envy. I'll get to your address in a little bit. Somebody ought to say amen. When you've been down long enough and you know that God is real, you'll celebrate him. Somebody ought to say amen. So rejoice today. Why? Because God is good. God is good. God is good. God is good. So well done, Brother Greg and Sister Donna. Well done for being the parents that you have been called to be to your children and grandchildren. Well done. Keep your head up. Well done. Well done. Well done. And to you young adults in here, my son Patrick and the rest of y'all 18 to 35, 40 years old, listen to me. Y'all may think we don't know what we're talking about. You don't understand. When you have children, your life needs to stop. Somebody ought to say amen. You still can't be popping it outside when you got cheering on the inside. I wish I had a witness, amen. And stop dating Tom, Dick, and Harry when you don't even know their last name. Come on now, say amen. I wish I had a witness in here. Because Billy Preston said like this, nothing from nothing, still leave nothing. Come on now, say amen. You got to have something if you want to be with me. Come on now, say amen. And some of you sisters, let me just give you this water before I take my seat. I might not ever preach again in this house like this again. But let me tell you something. Your sister, stop renting yourself out on the weekends. Come on now, say amen. Stop leasing that stuff. Come on now, say amen. If the brother can't purchase it, he don't need to be laying on it. I bought mine. When I got in my house, I paid for it. I got a license. I got a license. I can drive all day long. Deacons, you ready? Stay right there. You young people, we're getting off the scene. The church's gonna be in your hands. You need to be ready. The social media is fine. But that's for entertainment purposes only. It has no glory attached to it, has no salvation attached to it. And don't think your life belongs to yourself. Your life belongs to your family, and it belongs to the Lord Jesus. Come on, Brother Bart. We're going to commit right here, right? Preachers, would you meet me by the casket? Family, I'm going to ask you to stand. Family, in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, the Apostle Paul says this. What I'm saying, brothers and sisters, is this in verse 50. That flesh cannot inherit the kingdom of God, nor can corruption inherit incorruption. Listen, I am telling you a mystery. We shall not all fall asleep,
but we shall be changed. When this corruptible body is clothed with incorruptibility, and this mortal body is clothed with immortality, then the saying that is written will take place. Death has been swallowed up in victory. Oh, death, where is your victory? Oh, death, where is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who give us the victory through our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. Therefore, my beloved brothers and sisters, be ye that steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as you know, your labor in the Lord is not in vain. So it becomes our sad duty to commit our dear sister's body back into the ground, ashes to ashes, earth to earth, and dust to dust. Heavenly Father, we just thank you. Oh, we bless you. Father, continue to let your angels walk with this family. Strengthen them when they get weak. Remind them, God, that you will never leave them, never forsake them. Touch those whose hearts have been broken. Mend those broken hearts, Lord. Bring reconciliation in this family. And let the peace that surpasses all understanding continue to guard their minds and hearts in Christ Jesus. It's in Jesus' name we pray. And we say amen. I'm going to, you had anything you need to say, Pastor Brother Brock? Anything you need to say? On behalf of the funeral.
The only thing I can say is that we give our condolences to the family, but you know where our Mary and our party is, and this loss is just like a loss to the family of us. And we hope we did everything that we should have done, and we did everything we could do. And I just want to say, we want the family to stay together like we are, stay with your hands in Jesus' hands, and the Lord will heal with broken hearts. Thank you once again for giving us the opportunity to serve y'all. May God bless each and every one of you.
Thank you, sir. We're going to go ahead and check. God bless y'all so much. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you, baby girl. God bless you. Carl, you did a good job, man. Good job. Good job. God bless you, baby girl. God bless you. Hey, little one. Good to see you. God bless you, sir. God bless you, sir. God bless you, Mr. Patrick. God bless you, baby. So enjoy your music. Thank you. God bless you. Y'all need to sing too now. Y'all bring that line in a little bit, everybody. There you go.
I'm packing up, Lord, getting ready to go.